When police officers need to stop a car moving at high speed, ordinary measures don't always help. Did you know that modern technologies allow cars to be stopped without having to chase them? In this video, I'll tell you about the most interesting and effective devices for stopping vehicles. You'll learn how devices like MobileSpike, spike strips, and other technologies work. What are their pros and cons? How do these devices help prevent accidents and neutralize traffic offenders? Buckle up, we're starting! StarChase. How do you catch a criminal speeding away from a police car? You could chase them and create dangerous situations on the road, or you could use a device designed specifically for such cases. This is StarChase. It was invented in 2006 by the company StarChase Pursuit Management. The principle is that it shoots a projectile with a GPS tracker that attaches to the offender's car. One accurate shot, and the police can calmly track the car from a distance. As soon as the police decide that the chase is too dangerous, they fire the device. The projectile sticks to the offender's vehicle, and its coordinates are transmitted to a map. The police can slow down or stop the chase entirely while still monitoring the offender from a safe distance. The advantages of StarChase are obvious. It reduces the risk of accidents during a chase, decreases the burden on officers, and increases safety for all road users. However, there are also disadvantages. The main one is the high cost of the devices and the need for regular maintenance. Additionally, in some cases, GPS trackers can fail, especially in poor visibility or densely built-up city areas. I think it's a great option for stopping offenders without causing accidents. What do you think? Global Grab. Here's another device that can stop a car without a chase. Global Grab 400, invented in 2004, can capture a car like a net catching a ball, instantly stopping its movement. When a vehicle approaches, the system activates and releases a metal barrier that rises from the ground. The front wheels get stuck in the grid, blocking the vehicle without any sharp impacts or loss of control. What do you think? It's very convenient for checkpoints, secure areas, and places where it's crucial to quickly stop a potential threat. The benefits of this device are clear. It minimizes risks for police and bystanders, stopping the car smoothly and quickly. The system can also withstand significant loads. During testing, it stopped a 7-ton truck moving at 37 miles per hour. One downside is the system's cost. Installing Global Grab 400 can be quite expensive. It's used in various countries, especially in the US and Europe. In 2020, this device helped stop a car with an armed criminal at a US checkpoint. It not only saved the lives of the police, but also prevented a potential tragedy on the road. What do you think? Is this a reliable device? Let me know in the comments. Now I'll move on to the next device, which allows you to stop a car without even touching it. RF Safe Stop. RF Safe Stop is an innovative device designed for police and military use to safely stop vehicles without the need for physical contact. The device was first introduced in the early 2000s by the British company E2V Technologies. The principle of RF Safe Stop is to emit a directed beam of radio waves that interfere with the car's electronics, thereby disabling the engine control systems. This makes it impossible for the vehicle to continue moving. This device is very useful when traditional stopping methods such as spikes or barriers might be too dangerous. Among the main advantages of RF Safe Stop is its ability to prevent accidents and minimize risks for both the police and the offenders. It's particularly effective against modern cars equipped with advanced electronics. However, the device only works within a certain range, and its effectiveness may decrease depending on the protective systems of some cars. Also, the high cost of the device limits its widespread use. Despite these limitations, RF Safe Stop is being adopted by police and military forces worldwide. Its potential for reducing the number of chases and accidents is growing. How do you like this method of stopping a car? SABTECH Tyre Killer. The next device that helps police stop a car without resorting to dangerous maneuvers or high-speed chases is called the SABTECH Tyre Killer. Let me explain how it works. Special spikes embedded in the road activate when needed and puncture the tires of cars attempting to escape pursuit. This immediately brings the vehicle to a stop. The first versions of the device appeared in the 2000s and quickly found use among security services worldwide. When police deploy this device on the road, the chances of an offender's car continuing to move after the tires are damaged are almost zero. This reduces the likelihood of accidents, as high-speed chases become impossible. The device can be used in a variety of situations, from pursuing dangerous criminals to protecting entry points to highly secure areas. However, the SABTECH Tyre Killer only works in locations where it is installed, and it is not always effective against heavy vehicles with reinforced tires. Additionally, there is a risk of losing control of the vehicle when the device is used, which could create a potentially dangerous situation for other road users. So what's better? Risky chases or stopping with technology? XNet. The best system for safely stopping a car is considered to be the X-Net Chinetti Q system. This unique device allows police to stop a vehicle using a strong net that wraps around the wheels, gradually slowing it down. But you've probably heard of another method, spike strips, which are thrown onto the road to puncture tires. The major drawback of spikes is that a sudden loss of tire pressure can lead to complete loss of control over the car. This can endanger not only the driver, but also others, including the police themselves. The higher the speed, the more serious the consequences, and this is where X-Net wins. It doesn't puncture the tires, meaning the car slows down smoothly, minimizing the risk of an accident. The net wraps around the front wheels, filling the wheel arches, preventing them from rotating. As a result, the average distance to a complete stop is no more than 87 yards. Another advantage of X-Net is its mobility. It can be quickly deployed on any road. The net measures 5 by 3 yards and is stored in a special backpack in the trunk. It takes less than 20 seconds to deploy the net, and it can be reused if, of course, it can be pulled out from under the car. However, the system is designed for passenger vehicles and may be less effective against large trucks. Nevertheless, X-Net remains one of the best solutions for safely slowing down vehicles. Will X-Net be the future of police equipment? What do you think? MobileSpike. When a car needs to be quickly stopped on the road without endangering others, MobileSpike comes to the rescue. This system is unique in that it's mounted directly on a police car and is activated with the push of a button. Unlike traditional spike strips that are thrown onto the road, MobileSpike is mounted on the side of the vehicle and extends directly under the wheels of the pursued car. This approach allows the police to maintain control of the situation without blocking roads or creating additional obstacles for other drivers. MobileSpike was invented in the early 2000s and has already proven its effectiveness. The system can stop a car moving at up to 49 miles per hour. One notable example of its use occurred in the United States, where police used MobileSpike to stop a car thief attempting to flee at high speed. This helped prevent a potential disaster on a busy highway, and no bystanders were harmed. Among the advantages of MobileSpike is its precision. The system is activated exactly when needed, immediately neutralizing the threat. It also integrates easily into standard police vehicles. However, unfortunately, the device is not ideal for stopping large trucks or vehicles with high-profile tires. How do you feel about this method of stopping cars? Share your opinion in the comments. Spike Stinger. When a wanted criminal manages to escape and the safety of citizens becomes the top priority, Spike Stinger comes to the rescue. This simple yet effective tool is in the arsenal of police forces in many countries, from the US to Japan. Spike Stinger, or as it's commonly known, the spike strip, may not look very threatening. It's a set of spikes that are spread across the road. Imagine, this device can stop a car moving at speeds of up to 124 miles per hour. Punctured tires immediately lead to the vehicle coming to a halt, eliminating the need for a long and dangerous chase. But that's not all. Spike Stinger is easy to use and transport. A police officer can deploy it in just 5 seconds. However, there are some downsides. The time it takes to reset the device and the risk posed if an unrelated vehicle accidentally runs over it. Spike Stinger has become an indispensable part of the police's toolkit, providing a quick and safe way to stop cars. The next time you see police lights and feel the tension, know that this little hero of the road might be nearby. CrookHook. An adrenaline rush on the roads, cars speeding at full throttle, criminals trying to escape, but the police have a secret weapon up their sleeve, CrookHook. This brilliant tool helps stop fugitives and protect the innocent. In the early 2000s, Kevin Trigo dreamed of becoming a police officer. However, failed attempts to pass the entry tests kept him out of service. Despite this, Kevin continued watching reports of high-speed chases and noticed the same sad pattern. Most of them ended in crashes. While working as a forklift operator on construction sites, Kevin had an idea. Criminals need to be hooked like cargo. He invested 16 years and $100,000 into developing his invention, and he created CrookHook. The device consists of two steel profiles connected by a powerful spring and is mounted directly to the frame of a patrol car. The regular bumper wasn't strong enough for the task. CrookHook can be used in two scenarios. The first is when an officer stops a suspicious vehicle for a check. The officer approaches closely and activates the hook, securing the car without damaging it, preventing the suspect from fleeing. The second scenario is during a chase. After the hook grabs the suspect's car, the patrol officer brakes sharply, safely stopping the pursued vehicle. CrookHook has spread to the USA, Canada, Australia, and the UK. Police officers appreciate it for its ability to end chases quickly and without casualties. Devices like CrookHook are becoming indispensable tools for law enforcement. They prove that simple ideas can turn into reliable solutions that protect lives. Do you have any ideas on how to stop road racers? I'm waiting for your suggestions in the comments. Grappler Bumper. When it comes to chasing cars, police face tough challenges. But what if there was a way to instantly stop any vehicle without endangering lives? That's exactly why the Grappler Bumper was developed, a unique device that has already saved many lives and prevented accidents. Grappler Bumper was invented in 2007 in the USA. It's a special mechanism that police can use to stop a car when it tries to escape. How does it work? The Grappler Bumper is a mechanism with two long arms that extend and grab the rear of the car, wrapping around its wheel. This forces the car to stop. Even if the driver continues accelerating, the Grappler Bumper locks the wheel, bringing the vehicle to a halt. Grappler Bumper can stop a car moving at up to 62 miles per hour. However, it may not work if the vehicle has a low ground clearance. Grappler Bumper is used not only in the USA, but also in other countries, such as the UK and Australia. What do you think? Is this a safe method of stopping a car? Optima Mobile Hydraulic Road Blocker. When a criminal is speeding down the road, what can you do to stop them? The police use various technologies, and one of the most effective is the Optima Mobile Hydraulic Road Blocker, a mobile hydraulic blocking device capable of stopping any vehicle. Invented in 2012, the Optima Mobile Hydraulic Road Blocker allows law enforcement to block roads in situations where it's necessary to prevent dangerous actions by drivers. Here's how it works. When activated, special metal structures rise from the ground and block the vehicle's path, ensuring the safety of those nearby. The device can stop cars moving at up to 62 miles per hour. The advantages of Optima include ease of use and mobility. It can be installed wherever it's needed. However, there are some drawbacks. It takes time to install, and the blocker is ineffective in areas with limited visibility. Optima has become an important tool in the arsenal of police forces in the United States and the UK. Do you think it can make roads safer? Friends, today you've learned about the devices that help police safely stop cars. Now you know how these systems help prevent accidents and neutralize offenders on the roads. Which of these devices seems most effective to you? Maybe you know of other technologies used to stop vehicles? Share your thoughts in the comments. You've learned how the police keep order on the roads, but it's equally important to share this information with others. Quality content is what helps people learn about such useful technologies. If you want to be part of our team and help create videos, and if you enjoy telling stories about innovations, then we have great news. We're looking for talented people to help us create awesome videos. If you're good at editing, voiceover work in different languages, or writing creative scripts, we'd love to work with you. Send a message to our Telegram bot. The link is in the description. Don't forget to like the video if you found it interesting and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new episodes.